Perhaps you are in the market for a three-row SUV or crossover, but you want a little bit of luxury in your life. Now, you don't want to go full-bore Cadillac, you don't need a Mercedes, you don't need some of the offerings that are out there from other manufacturers like the Audi Q7, but you also don't want to go down market. There's a middle ground, the premium ground, and GMC's got you covered with the 2012 GMC Acadia. Usually when you're looking at a larger crossover, the looks can be mixed at best. You're finding a vehicle that's maybe a little too ungainly or trying to cram too much in a small space. The Acadia suffers from none of that. It looks great. It's very well done proportionally. It sits nicely on the wheels and tires. That said, there are some exterior bits that we don't love. GM has a love affair with this plastic chrome. It's junk. It looks horrible. It's like a fake metal that does nothing to the appearance of this car. Some people might think, oh, it's chrome. It's not chrome. It's plastic and it's gonna flake and then it's gonna look even worse. Though it does have these nice big looking headlights with the indicator right there. You get some more of this fake chrome on the bottom. We need to get away from this chrome. Moving down the side though, you do get away from some of that. There's some nice matte black here in the wheels to break up some of that again chrome. Then you have less chrome. It's just on these door handles. It's just on this trim. This is a much better use. Less is better with this stuff. Moving to the back, you've got a full size rear end here. Of course, more plastic chrome, but there's less than there is up front. So overall it works. If we ditch this, it would clean up the rest of the appearance greatly because otherwise it's a pretty handsome looking vehicle. Normally when you have a vehicle with the heft that the Acadia carries, you're expecting something equally hefty under the hood. Thankfully, however, that's not the case here. What we're dealing with is a directly injected 3.6 liter V6 engine. It's good for 288 horsepower and 270 pound-feet of torque. On top of that, if you opt for the front-wheel drive model instead of the all-wheel drive model, you're gonna get about 24 miles per gallon on the highway. That's pretty damn good with a vehicle like this. Furthermore, you can so equip it so that you can tow up to 5,200 pounds. So you can have a great tower, you can have solid fuel economy, and you're doing it with just a V6 engine. When it comes to a vehicle like this, cargo space is typically the name of the game. Thankfully, the Acadia delivers in spades. Hit the button, this will flip up automatically because we are dealing with a premium vehicle. Move inside and you've got good room here. Of course, you've got to make note that this is a three-row vehicle, so there will be a seat in your way. You're not always going to have three rows active though. So you can flap that down, it folds flat. If you need to get it back, you got this handy lever, pull it right back up. You can do the same thing on the other side. You got more room because it's a 60-40 split. You're good to go. There's plenty of room here. Once you're done, hit the button, close it all up, and you're on your way. At first glance, when sitting into the second row here of the Acadia, things look like they're going to be in a good spot for me. These seats are wonderfully padded. The material's great. They're soft. They're comfortable. But the leg room is abysmal. That's clearly first class, and it feels like I'm sitting in coach. But there's a nice little trick here. There's a button on the side. I pull it. I slide back and all of a sudden I've transformed coach into business class. This is a great place to sit now. I can watch a movie up here. I've got plenty of outlets down here. I've even got a 120 volt style home outlet so I can plug in my laptop and get some work done. Though if you're motion sick, you probably will puke and you don't want to do that because this is nice material. This is a great example of how a second row should be in a three row vehicle. You're going to have to cough up at least $33,000 if you want to jump into the base model Acadia SL. You're going to get some decent standard features there, but you're going to want to spend a few more bucks to get things like heated and cooled front seats, this wonderful leather system, this touchscreen infotainment, the heads-up display in front of me that displays the miles per hour in a huge display that's very easy to read. There's a lot of optional extras here, and if you're spending money for a premium vehicle, you might as well spend it. The vehicle we're in is the Acadia Denali. The creme de la creme in the Acadia world. This one, fully equipped, though you could go with an all-wheel drive, whereas this is a front-wheel drive, this car costs about $50,000. That's a lot of money, but premium vehicles are expensive and the interior matches that price point. It's very well done in here. Things feel nicely put together. This is the side of GM that has learned how to build a car better than it used to. GM's done a good job of making the Acadia a comfortable place to sit if you're the driver. We've also already talked about how it's a great place to sit if you're in the second row, but here up front, visibility is excellent, not just to the front, but to the sides and off to the back because there's a big greenhouse here. There's a lot of light coming in. I can see what's going on around me, and that's important with a vehicle of this size. It's not all about visibility though. We really care what is going on under the hood. We've already told you about the engine, and in here, it works really well. Put your foot down, and it delivers all that horsepower, and you go. Additionally, besides the forward momentum, there's good lateral movement. The steering is light. It's remarkably light. It's not quick like we're driving a sports car, but it's not heavy like we're driving a heavy-duty truck. It's exactly the type of weight we want in a vehicle like this. But with handling, you also have to think about braking. You can handle, a car can handle great, but if it doesn't stop well, the whole package falls apart. That doesn't happen here with the Acadia. Step on the brakes, vehicle comes to a smooth, easy stop. It's the combination of the suspension, the ride's soft, the handling is responsive, the brakes are there, and the engine responds in kind as well. All around, it's a great car to drive on short trips, on long trips. Speaking of long trips, we recently logged some serious seat time in this specific 2012 Acadia Denali. We left our Southern California headquarters and went north, camping in Yosemite, we went to Oregon, we went to Washington, and then we jetted over to Montana with a final cabin stop in Glacier National Park. That's some serious mileage, and this car's no worse for the wear, and neither are we. We're comfortable, the car remained comfortable, and we couldn't think of a better vehicle to take such a trip other than the 2012 GMC Acadia Denali.